Now let's have a look at how the income statement will change when there are changes to different accounts and adjustments that we have to take into consideration. So we're going to look at exactly the one we did in the previous two videos, but we're going to now turn the page and look at the extra information. So for now, we will see on page 256 this extra information. Malanga Sports bought the land and buildings for 530,000, so we know we are going to the balance sheet template because it is an asset and it's land and buildings. Since then, the shopping complex has been renovated and has become a very popular center. It is estimated that the value of the land and buildings is now 650,000. It's very important that you now realize that according to a GAAP principle, the historical cost, we record any asset at the price that we bought it at. So this 530,000 will stay the same and not become 650,000 because they don't tell us how much we paid that it has increased in value in that sense. They're just telling us that it has increased in value. In other words, we didn't pay anything extra for it. It is still the historical cost, but when we sell it, we hoping to get 650,000. So there's no change there. Then, the loan from Nedbank was taken out on 1 August at an interest rate of 15%. Loan belongs to this financial statement. Loan is not changing, but hang on, they say that loan is capitalized. So if the loan is capitalized, it means that we will have to take the loan as it is and add to it the interest. We don't know what the interest is, so let's calculate that. It is 15%. So to calculate the interest on the loan would be the loan amount of 10,000, then times the 15%, but only for the period of months that we had it. We had it from the 1st of August. So it's August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March, and April. Because it is 9 of the 12 months since our year end is in April. So that amount comes to 10,000 times 15. Percent times 9 divided by 12 is 1125. So that 1125 is my interest, and there's always two accounts involved. The other one is my interest expense, that's the interest on the loan. It was 0 before we turned the page. Now it is minus 1125 as we calculated it. The next bullet is saying a small room at the back of the shop has been rented out as a storeroom to Tini for dressmaking since August. Tini pays 800 rand rent per month. She still owes the rent for April. Okay, so what do we do with this? Think about all the adjustments we have done. We have dealt with accrued income. Accrued income is when we are expecting money to come in that